Oh, and when you leave, can you just leave straight away as well? We're not, there's a separate entry and a separate exit, and we're not supposed to have people standing around outside. That's a bit sad too, isn't it? But you're supposed to go straight home when you leave. And I guess we're all a little bit extra conscious at the moment too, aren't we, of the way things are. So we're all doing our best to help, even though the circumstances are a little bit different and not as good as we would like them to be. Never mind, we're here, aren't we? And we're here to celebrate Christmas and to enjoy hearing the story again and thanking God for sending us his Son to be our Lord and our Saviour. Through the past 4 weeks leading up to Christmas, we've been celebrating the season of Advent in the church, meaning arrival, time of coming, and we've been lighting an extra of the 4 purple candles each week. Until now, we've got all 4 candles lit. The first week of Advent, there was just the 1, then 2 the next week, then 3, now 4 are lit. But you can see the big white candle in the middle is not lit yet. So we'll be lighting that in just a little moment. So for those who may now be watching at home, welcome to you to our Christmas service, Christmas children's service tonight, family service. We're so glad that you're watching with us, whenever that might be. You can sing at home without your masks as much as you like. So welcome to everyone who's here this evening. We're going to stand for this first hymn, but then after that, I suggest you just remain seated while we sing through the service. So welcome everyone. Please stand as we sing Christmas is Coming, the Church is Glad to Sing. We've been singing the same words each week, and this last verse is a bit different tonight. Thank you, everyone. Would you like to sit now? And thank you, Freya, for helping us light the candle. Thank you. A Christmas prayer. Loving God, you know how excited we are as we wait to celebrate again the birth of Jesus tomorrow. We thank you for the joyful sound of carols, the warmth of families together, and the laughter of children. Thank you for always being with us, and we ask you to bless us all this awesome night. Amen. We're going to listen now to the beautiful Christmas story, the way that St. Luke tells it in his Gospel. For hundreds and hundreds of years, messengers of God said that one day God was going to send someone special into the world to build up and bring in God's kingdom. The people waited and waited and sometimes wondered if God had forgotten. But God did not forget. God was waiting for just the right time. Then one day something wonderful happened. A baby called Jesus was born, and during his life he showed everyone how much God loves them and wants to be with them. Let's sing the lovely words of the carol, Infant Holy, Infant Lowly. Stay seated to do this.
Christ the babe is born.
you know that before Jesus was born, God sent the angel Gabriel to a girl named Mary, who lived in the town of... Do any of the children know which town it was? Would you like to tell me? Bethlehem. No, they travelled to Bethlehem, but she was living somewhere else. Does another young person want to venture a try? It was Nazareth. The angel told Mary that God had chosen her to give birth to a holy child who would be named Jesus. That's what you're going to say, isn't it? Jesus. The angel then told her that this special child would become great and would be known as Emmanuel, God with us. Emmanuel, God with us. Mary was surprised and wondered, why did God choose me? But Mary wanted to do what God asked of her and said to the angel, I will be glad to serve the Lord. We're going to hear about that now as Paul and Noreen and Anne stand to sing The Angel Gabriel Came, and you can join in too if you want to. After visiting Mary, the angel also appeared in a dream to Joseph, whom Mary was going to marry. The angel told Joseph about the very special baby that Mary was going to have. A few months later, the Emperor Augustus decided to find out how many people lived in his country. So everybody was to travel back to their hometown to be counted. Mary and Joseph set out on a long journey from Nazareth to the town of Bethlehem, where Joseph's family came, where they came from. The roads were pretty windy and rocky, and sometimes they had to go up and down hills. They were getting very tired when suddenly they saw Bethlehem in the distance. Let's sing about the little town of Bethlehem together.
Oh, little town of Bethlehem.
Now, do any of the children know what happened when Mary and Jesus made it finally to Bethlehem? What happened when they got there? Yes, Freya? What happened when they got to Bethlehem? Oh, before the baby was born, something happened, or actually didn't happen. They were looking for somewhere to stay, and there wasn't anywhere, was there? Quite right, they had to go to the stable. Bethlehem was so crowded with people coming from everywhere back to their hometown to be counted, and all the inns were filled with people. Everywhere they went, the owners would say, "No, sorry, we're all filled up, no room for you." Mary and Joseph were getting a bit worried, of course, because Mary was about to have her baby and they wanted to find shelter. At last, a kind innkeeper said, "My rooms are all filled, but I have a stable that you can use if you want to. The cattle are there and some cows and donkeys, but they won't bother you." So off they went to the stable. And during that night, Jesus was born. And we might get Daphne to put baby Jesus in the manger, because there was no cot for baby Jesus, was there? No cot for him to go in. So they laid their newborn baby in a manger. Now, what's a manger?
A manger is something
they eat their food out of the manger, don't they? Hay or straw. Other children, if you know the answer, you'll have to get in quick before Freya, because she knows all the answers. So put your hand up, and if you know the answer to my next question, then I'll ask you, and if you don't know, we'll ask Freya. But that's wonderful. So they placed their baby in the manger, nowhere else for him to go. It's usually what the animals eat their food out of, but it was a comfortable, and it might have been a bit scratchy, do you think? But Jesus went to sleep in the manger. And so let's sing one of the most beloved of all the children's carols, "Away in a Manger." Stay seated, please. Mary and Joseph were still in that stable looking after Jesus, something very amazing and wonderful and unusual was happening outside, up on the hillsides outside Bethlehem. The whole area was suddenly filled with light, and an angel appeared. And look, an angel is appearing here among us now, a beautiful little angel. just, if Daphne or Patsy could just, up there would be, somewhere there would be lovely. She could sit if she wants. The angel appeared. Thank you, Frank. The shepherds were frightened, but the angel said to them, "Don't be afraid, I've come to tell you some really good news." The angel told the shepherds that a wonderful thing had happened. A baby had been born in Bethlehem who would come to lead people to God. Then the angel told them where they could find Jesus. That was in the stable, wasn't it, Freya? You know that. Suddenly, lots of angels appeared and they all began to sing and praise God for the birth of Jesus. Now, the shepherds decided to see if the angels were right and they went off looking for Jesus. We're going to sing about the angels singing to God now. We've had real angels with us while we were singing, haven't we? Wasn't that fabulous? Thank you. So the angels were witnesses singing glory to God. And of course, we're to do that too, children and grown-ups, about how much God loves us, all the good things God gives us in our lives, and to tell others how great it is to know that God sent Jesus for us. Others came too to worship Jesus. Wise men called, now, does any of the children know that other name for wise men? Magi. You've heard that word before, have you? Magic comes that word, the magi, wise and learned people. Yeah. That's right, magic. Yeah, that's good. Good girl. That's right. They came too a little later from far away, bringing expensive gifts. Now, none of us probably can bring really expensive gifts to offer God in gratitude for God's love for us, but it helps us to know that what delights God's heart more than anything else is when we bring the gift of our loving, grateful heart and ourselves, as Mary did, offering ourselves, saying, "Thank you, God, for all the good things that you've given us and for your love for us." That's what counts for God more than anything else. And we can do that, can't we? Every day, children and grown-ups too. And a grateful heart is such a wonderful thing to have. And with our grateful hearts, we're going to say some prayers together. Your responses will be on the screen. And Daphne will lead us now in some prayers of gratitude to God.
Dear God, We are so excited about Christmas tomorrow. We want to pray for children, families, and all people for whom Christmas is not a good time at all, for all sorts of reasons. Thank you that Jesus promised us that you hear us when we ask in faith. Please hear these prayers now. We pray for all who will be alone tomorrow. Please bring them a friend, someone to be with them. We remember all who will be hungry tomorrow. May there be enough food for everyone. Thank you for those who will be sharing Christmas tomorrow with a needy, hungry person. Thank you for organisations like Samaritans who are taking Christmas lunch to lots of hungry people. We pray for all who have no home. May they find a safe place of shelter where they are made welcome. We pray for all the refugees in our world. We remember especially refugees living in detention in Australia or Nauru and the little family on Christmas Island, all alone in detention there. Thank you, God, that you sent Jesus, that everyone would know that Jesus came to share your love with everyone. Dear God, bless children everywhere. The very old and frail, babies. The sick and those who suffer in any way, those with no jobs, the lonely and sad, everyone. Make us generous and kind in our care of others. May all the world know your goodness and care. Amen. Let's say thank you to God in the prayer Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
We are going to stand again together now as we share God's peace. And the way we have to do that at the moment is in a non-physical way, so we can wave peace to each other. Please stand, everyone. We are the body of Christ.
In spirit with us.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
God's peace. Peace be with you all. God's peace. God's peace, singers. Thank you. And we sing our offertory hymn. Thank you for the donations you may have made as you came in, because we don't send a bowl of asking for your offerings through the service at the moment, but there is a bowl at the back, and of course your donations go to help the work that our church does here in Lambton and in the wider world. So your generosity is appreciated. Let's sing as we prepare for communion. Please be seated. Please be seated.
Joyful and joy,
thank you.
Oh, God, be your God.
Thank you, God, for all your gifts to us. Thank you for hearts and hands to serve you, for songs to sing, for love to share, and gifts like this money to give. May all our gifts be used to help families in need. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Would you stand for this next part of this great Thanksgiving prayer? We thank you, loving God, for in Jesus you have come to dwell among us. You have entered our world and made your home in our hearts. We praise you for your affirming love. We thank you for making us whole. When we were afraid, you offered us peace. When we are lost, you show us the way home. And so we praise you with all the company of heaven rejoicing in one voice. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You call us to this feast this day, O Lord. You are the host and we are privileged to be here. By your word and through your grace, we are fed and nurtured. Let your spirit come upon us, and may this bread and wine be for us the food of eternal life. We remember that on the night of his betrayal, Jesus took bread, and when he had given you thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup and again giving thanks, he prayed, "This is my blood of the new covenant. It is shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Drink from this, all of you." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Gracious Saviour, in this meal we would know perfect communion with you. In the eating of this bread and the drinking of the wine, may we be one forever. May all humanity be one, caught up in your love until the end of time. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. We who are many are one body, for we all share in the one bread. Brothers and sisters, I invite you, if you wish, to come forward for communion, maintaining the spots on the floor. You would know, most of you, that I can't give you the wine at the moment, but at the end I will raise the chalice and I will say the blood of Christ for me and for you. If you would like to come forward just for a blessing, please know that we'd love you to do that too. Having had you here with us this evening. We hope that you can go home and enjoy your final preparations for Christmas Day tomorrow and have a really wonderful day tomorrow, wherever you are and whoever you're with. And those of you at home, this prayer is for you too as you watch this service in your homes. So thank you everyone for coming. Of course, we'd love to see you back again every Sunday, 9 o'clock. We're here and we would love to see everyone who wants to come. Please stand as I offer you God's blessing. This is the night on which Jesus was born. May the joy of his coming be in our hearts. May his love fill our souls. May the hope of the gospel be in us forever. May we share God's blessings with everyone we meet. And may the blessing of God, Creator, Redeemer, Sanctifier, be with you and those you love and those you find difficult to love too, this day and always. Amen. We can't have a Christmas service without finishing with Joy to the World. Please remain standing.